Hey, it's Trey, and thanks for stopping by my desk this evening. So I want to introduce you to my little random book. So Nicole at Relax Cut Glue, Nicole's Relax Cut Glue, whatever. I want to make sure I'm saying it right, but if you're in the glue book world, I'm sure you know Nicole. She has one. And I was at a Goodwill. I don't know why I can't talk. Give me a minute. I'll warm up. And I was just looking through the books and I saw this one there and I pulled it out. And I just started looking at it. And it's from the 50s, I think. I must have glued over it or accidentally ripped it out. But anyways, I just kind of started flipping through it and it was just like I fell in love with it. So I brought it home with me and I ripped out a bunch of pages to make it flatter so I could add more. So you can kind of see like here, like gaps where I just ripped out pages, and I just went in and just would rip out, well, like this, just like that. You know, I just ripped them out here and there and whatever. And so, and part of the reason of really even doing this, and I think the reason why it just felt so good in my hand at Goodwill, because that's really what happened. It's just like, I want to take this book home with me. I want to put images in it. It just feels so good in my hand. I want to make it chunky. Does that ever happen to you guys? It's because I found this box. Let me see if I can pull it over. It's a mason jar box. And it is absolutely just our... You kidding me? Who am I, Dee Dee Willingham? I mean, oh my word. Oh my word. And you have no idea how much more stuff that I've got that I can go through. Like books and magazines and more's coming every day. Willow, was that you? I have a little shark that is circling my feet. I don't know which one it is yet. We'll find out. Who is it? Knock, knock. They haven't learned who's there. All right, so anyways, we get everything back in order. So I found that big box, and I was just like, okay, I'm going to get it, and I'm just going to take that box. I'm just going to start filling images in it. And that's exactly what I done. And I put a few images in the front. I'm going to leave this as is. I'm going to leave this as is. I wish I would have left the copyright, but it's gone, and there's nothing I can do about that now. It seems like I glued some stuff, and then I went, oh, crap, let me look. And it was already gone, so I think he got pulled out. So these are all just random kind of stuff. Some themes are kind of happening. You can kind of see a little theme going on there. Mainly how I do it is just randomness, but I try to do colors together. As you can kind of see, this has greens in it. This has greens. Even though, you know, then you got kind of like this greenish blue. So this greenish blue works. So, I mean, that's kind of what I do. That's from White Castle. Our nearest White Castle is an hour away, and you know what? We absolutely will drive an hour to go to White Castle. We used to do it on Jeremy's birthday, which was which is the day after Christmas. But we haven't done that in a long time. Maybe we should resurrect that because that was fun. What day is Christmas on this year? I have to look to see if it even works. So as you can see, this is Yankee Candle. And what I did is I had this catalog page and I had cut it out because I like the uniformity of the candles. And I pasted it down and then I saw the candles and I thought, you know what? It'd be fun if I just like cut them all out and just put them everywhere. So I covered all the like descriptions like with these and then I just had them scattered everywhere like they're falling down because I didn't want to cover up Jack and me. So I thought that was a good idea. Thumbs up if you thought that was a good idea. I'm hoping to get some more candles or find some more. I'm sure I have some more, and then I can come back and maybe add some more. So yeah, stay tuned. But yeah, there's some more writing here. I think what really sold me on getting this is, let me see if I can find it. I probably can't. We'll come up on it. There it is. Is that?1963. So I'm going to preserve that. So even though I don't know when the book was, this was 1963. So I'm keeping that. And then there's a couple of other little drawings in here that I'm keeping. So yeah. Like I'll probably keep that. But like that says homework September 7th. Nah, I'll probably go over that. Oh good old glue cap or bottle cap. I do use a glue stick in this, and the reason why is because it's just so dang easy. Because you can just glue it and go. So, I've had this fish forever. I cut him out. He was like one of the very first things I cut out. And then I just hated it. And I was like, I'm never going to use that. So I ended up cutting him out. And then I highlighted some kind of like some things that's politically incorrect and probably going to be politically incorrect soon. So yeah. So I was glad that he finally has a home. But I thought this would be fun just to kind of just the more than I'm doing it because I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to do it and see what happens. Really like this. And I'm thinking that this can kind of that I can maybe build on this. Maybe there's some themes that can kind of come out. Some of it is randomness. Like that was complete randomness. I haven't really put a lot of focal anything in here. It's mainly just backgrounds. And that's my focus, is mainly just doing some backgrounds and going through this box of images. I love that. Oh, I'm so happy to be able to use this on the borderline that divides the known landscape from the unknown abyss. That came from an art book, and I think this looks good with it. And I'll probably do nothing else with this except for maybe add some other kind of focal thing on here. But we'll see. I freaking love this contact paper. It's by Duct Tape. They also used to make a washi tape in it, and there's no fallout, and it's just completely smooth. And it is so freaking sparkly. I just love it. In fact, I put some of it on my dance bag. I just got a new dance bag. In fact, that's what I've been working on. So, yes, ma'am. So happy. This is a napkin. I love this napkin. It's just so great. I'm so glad I got it. I don't even remember where I got it now. Seems like it might have been like at Ross or Marshall's. Pumpkins. That's how we say it in the South. Pumpkins. You want some pumpkin pie? Hey, pumpkin. I love that image. That's from a video game, I believe. So, yeah, this is what I was working on when I said, you know what? I'm going to turn on the camera. These came off from the art book. This one was a cool one. I think this is when I decided really to turn on the camera and play around. I thought, oh, man, that was so cool. So this was just a whole image. And I ended up ripping her and putting half of her that ripped up here. And then I ripped it again and put some of it down here. And it left this. And I thought, man, that looks like a hat. So I put it on. And I love it. It looks like she's wearing a hat. And I'm just so freaking happy. I don't know, guys. There's just something about that when you do something and it comes together and you're just like, what the what? When you impress yourself with something that you do, it's just amazing. I'm sitting here shaking my leg. I hope I haven't been shaking the camera. I just realized that. Oh, I hate when I do that. Fidget. I used to fidget a lot when I was younger, but I've learned to control it. But sometimes when I'm concentrating, it slips out. Oh, man. Oh, come on. This is a napkin, by the way. And I had already pulled off the back. Ah! You're not cooperating at all. This is your big debut! Okay. I almost went. Is that really necessary? Oh. Follow me for more glue booking tips. Okay. Now I'm just kind of trying to dry it because it is a napkin, so it's kind of sneaking through. Oh, English. You've evaded me so. I do, English, hey, I got an excuse. I'm Southern. We speak our own brand of English. Haven't you guys noticed? I often wonder if sometimes there's things that I say that people have no idea what I mean. Just because it's a Southern expression. I try to be mindful of that. And if I use a Southern expression, and if I catch myself, then I try to either repeat it with something more commonly known or, I don't know. Explain it, I guess. Like, butter my biscuit. Well, butter my biscuit. That is a Southern expression, meaning that, isn't that great? And if you were in Fargo, it would be, well, that's fantastic. Right? Isn't that what they say in Fargo? I haven't watched Fargo in forever. Check my sign of my book here. All right, let's go to the back. Oh, I hear Jeremy, so let me pause and see what he needs. I have returned. Did you miss me? Jeremy came up to heat up a sandwich. And so I went in and talked to him while he was up here. And he went back downstairs to listen to his music and enjoy his evening. I don't know what I want to put on this page. This page is probably going to end up being an art journal page. It's pretty heavy. So I'm trying to be mindful of that. Because Kill Devil Hills. Jeremy and I were going to move there when Kenan graduated high school. We were going to and go that way. Migrate somewhere near Kill Devil Hills, Ocean Isle, that kind of area. And now Jeremy's telling me that he wants to stay here in this house and retire here. And I'm just like, what? That wasn't the plan. That wasn't the plan at all. Love this. Love that. Like, that was not the plan at all. What the heck? What have plans changed? But they have, so now I have to kind of change what I thought was going to be happening. Which is fine. I mean, it's not like I don't want to stay here. This house is great. This area is great. God blessed us greatly with this house, let me tell you. Oh, I made a line, but it's okay. You see the line? I keep leaning into the shot. I tell you, I'm the just... my YouTube skills, top knot. So we went to Colorado back in, oh shoot, I don't even remember now, October, yeah. It was the first time Jeremy flew. It was great. We were celebrating our 10-year anniversary. It was a really hard decision whether to go or not. And I'm telling you, it was nerve-wracking. Ugh, I would not want to have to go back in time and make that decision again. But we decided to go for it because we figured if we went to Colorado, we could just hang out in our hotel room and be outside. Like drive and walk. That kind of stuff. And that's pretty much what we did. We went to like the zoo. We went to the botanical garden. There was something else we did and I cannot remember for the life of me. Every single time I forget that third thing we did. It was such a whirlwind, guys. I tell you, when you go with Jeremy on a trip, it is go, go, go. From sun up to sun down. You live every moment. We saw so much. We went everywhere. And I vlogged some of it. Don't want a hair background. I think that's too much hair. I'm just reading the examples. Sorry. what was I saying? Oh, it's of no consequence. Oh, vlogging. So, yeah. So, I have all these vlogs and stuff that I took in Denver. I mean, I just took different videos. I didn't really vlog so much because it was kind of difficult with the mask and all that. So, I did take video with the intention of, like, doing some voiceovers and that kind of stuff. That's not bad together. And Jeremy expressed, desire to take over our vlogging channel and learn how to do the video and editing and all that. And I'm like, heck yeah, yes, do it. Because it's kind of hard when you film it all and you edit it all. And I'm just like, yeah. So he's like, I'll do the Colorado vlogs. And that way I'll have I'll do those. They'll be my first ones or whatever. I'm like, yeah, that'd be great. Has he done it? Nah. Will he ever do it? Nah. Dang it. You know, I thought he was going to help me. So I guess I just need to really buck it up and just go and edit them and start putting them up. Because it was the first content that we have put up in a long, long time. I think I've shared with you guys before reasons of why we stopped vlogging. Mainly having to do with my son. And just putting my son out on the internet. I just grew uncomfortable with that. Even him being older, I just... I was just like, no, what am I doing? So, luckily, the videos that are very popular on my channel... don't really include canon. They're just how-to stuff. So, ooh, I like that side now. Oh. Change of plans. Flip it and reverse it. I need a little soundboard and I could just hit a little button and Missy Elliott would say, flip it and reverse it. Since God knows they're not going to make me make any money on these videos. Not anytime soon. I kind of like that. There you go. See, happy accidents. There you go. That's the randomness right there. Don't ever be afraid to rip your pages up, your images up, whatever. Because let me tell you, there are always going to be more images out there. There are always
going to be more images out there.
I would like to see the CC for that, to see how many times I just said always. Don't be saving crap for a special occasion. But I do tell you what I do. I have 3 different books. I'll even be so kind as to stop what I'm doing right now and show them to you. Because they are right here to my left side. I have this one. I have this one. Excuse me. Hopefully that wasn't the Rona. Alright, and I got this one. Alright, this is just a regular sketchbook, as you can see. And I kept this on it so that I would know. Jeremy's mom got me this probably 2 years ago. This goes here, but I need to use a different glue on it because it's not sticking. So yeah, I did this in 2018. So this is like art, kind of like an art journal. And it's images that I just really love, or an art journaling thing that I just really, really, that I just really wanted to keep. Like, it's the climb that makes us strong. You know, this I was going to do a like D.D. Willingham style kind of universe thing with all that, and I've never followed through with it. I just put it on there, and then I just kind of fell in love with it the way it was, and I just liked it, so I left it. I remember Jeremy's like, why did you put it over her eyes? And I'm like, it's a statement. Because it's like, bring your plans to the light. But she's blinded. And he was like, huh? And I said, it's art. I didn't even date that one. Here are my cats. So I have this, which really did just kind of start off as an art journal. Oh, these stick so bad. And then it became just a place where I put not only art journals, but images that I love that I just connected with. Like this girl, I really connected with her, and I connected with this image right here so strongly. So I kept it with this book. These two. I love these images. So I didn't really even do anything really except for just put down a sentiment to remind me to be strong. Why can I not turn the page? That's just paint I just wiped off. And then this is just, I pulled it out of a magazine and I loved it and I wanted to keep it. So there you go. And these two. They're just, they struck me. They made me feel a particular way. And I didn't ever want to lose them. So, yes, like this color, it is everything. I love this color. My hair was this color for the longest time. And then I did purple. And then purple's been kind of been my thing. And now it's gray. And people are driving me crazy because they want me to go back to purple. I love that image. I love that image. I love this image. These went so great together. It says uniquely designed. But yeah, I mean, this was just an advertisement, but it just made me feel this. I don't know. These, I loved them. Even this, Charmed. I didn't even watch Charmed. I watched Charmed the first season. By the time this, but this. Image. Wanted to keep it just like this. I didn't do anything to that. It's just in my book. And this was me. Let's just say I was journaling out some thoughts. I'll put something over that and you'll never even know it was there. Then I have this size. And we'll go from the back. So here I've just been putting down some images that I just really love. And then this is more of an art journal kind of thing. But yeah, you can kind of see that some of this is just images that I just adore. I just adored that. That's so beautiful. This picture right here of the cemetery. I love it. This. Oh, I just love it. That. So yeah, these books just really started becoming, rather than an art journal, they just became Yeah, there's, I guess I do still art journal in them, but they also, like this, I don't even have it tacked down. I just have it barely tacked. I can't remember if I glued her down or not. She's glued down. I went ahead and glued her down. But like this, I just barely tacked it in there because I'm not sure what I want to do with it yet because it's not a full page. So I've got these two because I'm not sure yet. So yeah. So, all right. I'm going to bring the sidetrack train around and let's get back onto what we were doing. Thank you for riding the crazy train. Do that one, yeah. So we're going to just put you right here because we just need to get on with the show here. So how's everybody been doing? Has everybody been staying safe and healthy? We have for the most part, although we have been exposed, which is always nerve-wracking. But it has happened to us, more than once because he is an essential employee, so. Everything turned out fine. I mean, we're out of quarantine and all that. And really, the other people in that person's household didn't even get it. So weird, eh? It's just such a weird thing. It really weird, really, really is. I just, I'm trying to line it up, but I don't know. I can't tell where it lines up. Dang, why do I keep coughing now? Oh, look at the kitty paws. Look at you. Super cute. You may have to go in the book without your tail. Would you be okay with that? Ooh, I see some lemons. That's too big though, because then now I'm covering up the Ferris wheel, but not too much, I guess. Could do it that way. Guess I could rip it. Thanks, Brain. You're welcome. Nice, I like it. So yeah, so right now the goal is to really just kind of lay down some background images. I mean, by all means, if something like pops to mind or whatever, I'll go with it. But yeah. So mainly this is it, just to kind of to lay some stuff down. I'm trying to lay some stuff on the edges because it's so tempting just to cover the text, but then the page edges become floppy and it makes it hard to flip the book. So I'm trying to go to the edges when possible so that it's strengthened. But trying to stay out of the ditch, kinda. I don't know. I haven't really been. That was a dang old lie. Just lied to y'all. Because look, you look back. Have I been trying to stay out of that ditch? Well, there I have. Well, maybe I have. Maybe I haven't been lying to you, but I have been trying to kind of stay out of the ditch because then that's what really breaks your spine so much. Yeah. Color. I love it when the colors come together. Keep flipping to that guy. I don't know if I like him. I don't want to work on this section. Let's go back to the back. Mr. Fish. Let's go in the middle here. Nobody's been in here. We haven't been in here at all. At all. Fresh new section. Let's open it up. Break that spine. Make it all loosey-goosey. And see, if you work in different sections in your book, and then you start using some of the same designs. Now, this kind of gives that same design that I just used on that other page. So, I wouldn't want to use it right there because that's exactly where I used it in the other page. So, I think I'm going to put it down here. What do your Thanksgiving plans look like? We are going to Jeremy's aunt's house. We are cooking mashed potatoes and then my signature dish, which is a cranberry apple casserole. My aunt makes it as a side dish, but honestly, I love it as a dessert, and I usually eat it as a dessert. It has like apples and cranberries in the filling, and of course sugar. And you mix all that together, and then on top you crumble like oatmeal. Shoot, what kind of oatmeal is it that I usually get? I forget. I guess cinnamon and spice, I think is what it is. Or a spice roll or cinnamon roll or something like that. And you add more sugar to it, of course, and then you crumble it up and put it on top. And oh my word, it is so good. That sweetness, that tartness, all day, every day. It's so good. It's kind of funny, the first time I made it, my mother-in-law was very skeptical. She just, she did not want to take a bite. Ooh, that's nice. So she got like a little tiny dab on her plate. And then she went and sat down, and then she got up and got another big thing of it. And then the next gathering we got, she said, "Will you make that apple cranberry thing?" I was like, "Yeah, absolutely. I will make you that apple cranberry thing." All right, can I switch the colors over like this? I guess I can. It does have a lot of yellow. If I could find something that would go here, that would bring in the yellow and the red. Does it do it? And then I've got some words right here, which I do not like. If I do it that way, then I'm cutting off the yellow and the red. But I can hear Nicole yelling at me and telling me that I'm overthinking it. Thank you, Nicole. You're absolutely right. I am overthinking it. Oh, don't want to go in that ditch too much. What a great pattern. What about Black Friday shopping? What's up with that? Y'all doing Black Friday shopping? What? we never did Black Friday shopping, so that does not... doesn't have anything to do with this. We've always worked on Black Friday, so... And Jeremy works this Black Friday, and even though I'm off, I'll probably still work. I'll probably still sign in and work. It'll be nice because it'll be quiet because nobody else will work, be working. So I won't be, be disturbed. And I still get my holiday pay. Hello, guys. Oh, I thought that rose was on. That was hilarious. If I run out of things to say, then I need to go. I'm thinking of just sitting here listening to the cats rumble. Starting to get a little bit of a headache. My allergies are just so bad. But honestly, that's just part of living in the South. So yeah, I get a headache just about every time this at night. What time of year? Because it's like my body's like, okay, look, just go to bed. It's late, just go to bed. But, oh man, I taken tomorrow off and I didn't want to, I don't want to waste this time. I want to use it. That purple, is not going to go. Keep trying to force it. You know, you can't go wrong with gray, honestly. Let's just do it. Oh, I've got to finish up my holiday shopping. I got a lot of it done for Kenan, and I've got some done for Jeremy. And he just gave me another idea tonight that I need to follow up on because I know he'll love it since he did suggest it. He was very, very excited about it. Because it's with Jeremy, because this is what we do for Christmas. I'll tell you this, and then I'll go. How's that? Because I need to go drink some water to stave off this headache and take some Mucinex. But anyways, what I am saying is that, dang it, it's just, maddening. It's just like a hair off of what you need. That's when you're like, oh, serendipity. Look how great that looks. Look how great that looks. I love it. I love it. Other things we can make. If we just line it up. I think I just like it like that. I like it like that. So for Christmas, we usually get each other 7 gifts. And then stockings. Well, this year we're going to do 5 gifts, which is fine. But then he said he wanted to do 5 gifts and a bonus gift, because our 5 gifts is mainly like stuff that we've asked for. Like, I made him a Christmas list and he's bought stuff off of it. He's like, I want one that's just a completely random gift that I haven't asked for. You just ran to something random. I'm like, okay. So I did actually get, I had already gotten him something like that, because it's pretty easy for me for Christmas, because I don't have to really worry about like 7 gifts or whatever. I buy whatever I want to, because Jeremy's birthday is the next day. So whatever I don't give him for Christmas, I just give him for his birthday. So I don't have to lament about, what should I give him? I only got 5 gifts. I just pick out 5-7 things, whatever we agreed on for that year, and that's that. That's that, honky cat. It would cut it off, but I think I'm going to do it. Because I like it. I like it like that. Oh, there we go. Glue. I was like, what the? It took my mind a minute to like comprehend what was going on. That's when you know you're tired, when you just look at it and it's like, what? Okay, the glue stick's done, and with that, I'm done as well. Thank you for hanging out with me. What are you guys working on? Just hit me up down below and tell me what you guys are working on. Let me know what you're all doing for Thanksgiving. And let me know what you want for Christmas. Y'all got a Christmas wish list? You know, I have an Amazon wish list. I mainly put like coloring books and stuff on it that I find that I like. So, I'm going to link it down below, and you can check out my wish list. There's some freaky coloring books on there, so. All right. And, yeah, my address is on there, so you can send me a stupid coloring book if you wanted to. All right. I'll talk to you later. Bye, guys.